Swift Blue's first month in the Highlands was about settling into a rhythm and building a confidence in a new home, and the second month has been about starting a training and establishing some rules and guidelines. I actually feel that some progress has been made on the training front this month, despite a few days when it's felt like we needed to start everything again from scratch. The highest priority starting the month was getting Blue to walk on the lead so that we could both enjoy her two walks a day. Up until that point, for 60 to 70% of the time, she was in drag the human mode with a mad lunge every couple of minutes to keep it all interesting. So the walks were actually pretty miserable for both of us, and given her energy levels, there was no way to avoid the need to put her on a lead and walk her twice a day. By the end of the month, drag the human behaviour is down to about 10% of the time, and lunging is occasional rather than regular on walks with zero distractions. However, if other people or dogs are around, her high drive to say hello and be stroked means that lunging is back up there as a favourite activity. Calming this behaviour has involved a lot of luring with treats, stopping, turning round, walking back the way we came, and walking very, very slowly until she stopped dragging. The lunging has lessened simply by stopping and only starting to walk again when she's not pulling. She started to walk naturally at heel for a noticeable amount of the walks, but this is really only about bribery and luring and her high food drive. The second big driver this last month has been based around her teething, and now, fortunately, most of her adult teeth are coming through. However, teething has made a victim of the trees in the garden, any logs, and has fueled her ongoing addiction of choice, which is tennis balls. Toys that are not of a Kong quality and robustness just haven't lasted. However, there are two standout chew toys which do just keep giving. These are a deer antler and an Antos Origins root, which she keeps going back to again and again and again. On the subject of Kong toys, the wobbler is something that will distract her for a good 10 or 15 minutes, but dealing with the barking requires nerves of steel. On the first walk of the day, when there are no other walkers about and up behind the house, I can actually let her off the lead, and I've been working on her recall and check-in with very mixed results. The reason for rewarding her every time she checks in is to keep the distance she wanders off manageable, and obviously recall is just a must-have with a dog.
Yes.
She is much better at check-in than recall, which she seems to perceive as a message that something very interesting is happening around her, and if she feels like it, she comes back. Whereas she has worked out that checking in regularly just means more treats. She grew out of her original harness and collar, and I replaced them with some excellent versions from Dog Copenhagen. The harness is way better at applying some control over pulling, and the collar is padded. In terms of other training, she's good on sit, which I now use more as a stop than anything else, and she's good on lie down and continues to improve with the stay and wait commands. She's already good at going to a bed in the crate when asked, but that's probably because she's had 2 months of receiving a treat when she does.
Yes.
The afternoon walk is a sensory overload sniff and smell extravaganza for her at the local dog walking trail, which is effectively a meandering dog toilet, and the trick is watching her closely to stop her eating every offering by every dog, including herself, that has ever walked there. I did start playing tug with her, but given the teething, I decided to leave it until all her adult teeth have come through. In terms of food, I continue to be really impressed with the butternut box dog food, and her coat is splendidly healthy. I've moved to platinum kibble instead of the ridiculously expensive dog treat offerings, and large tubs of whole food peanut butter for her Kongs, as it doesn't contain xylitol and is again less expensive than the dog branded peanut butters. Puppy training and one-to-one dog training continue every week, and hopefully the progress will continue as a result. Training goals for the coming month include all of the above, plus getting her to go and stay on a specific place despite any distractions, to work on a release command, to go from lie down to sit or stand, and more lure-based training to keep her brain working. It's all good.